Welcome everyone to this episode of Autocar Professional Dialogue. My name is Ujjal Nair and today we are at the Bangalore office of Visteon Corporation. We have with us today Mr. Sachin Lawande, President and CEO of Visteon Corporation.
Thank you.
Welcome to Autocar Professional, sir.
Thank you very much.
So, we have gone across this report where it says that the global automotive display market is going to be expecting a revenue of around $32.6 billion by 2024. So, coming to this industry, we would like to know what is your insight, what are your perspective on the trends that is driving this market?
So, first of all, the cockpit electronics market, as you said, is over $30 billion. So, it's a very sizable market. And Visteon is one of the global leaders in this segment of the industry. This industry has three main product categories. So the first one is infotainment. The second are clusters. And the third are displays. Right. So when you look at this industry from the segmentation viewpoint, right. We have instrument clusters. Visteon is the global leader. We are the market share leader in the world. We are number two in displays, and we have a lot of opportunity going forward with infotainment. So we are very well positioned to take advantage of what's happening in this industry on all the three product categories. And we see ourselves as also the technology and innovation leader in this space.
Okay, so when you said about technology and innovation, let's get on with the mega trends, like the electric vehicles, the autonomous vehicles, the connected solutions, the Android-based infotainment systems. We would like to know what are the strategies incorporated by Visteon in, you know, meeting these demands.
Right. So the macro trends that you observe, that you just mentioned, electric vehicles being one of them. We are extremely fortunate that we are agnostic to the drivetrain. So our technologies in the cockpit work very well, whether it is a conventional ICE engine or an electric vehicle. So we have been able to take advantage of the industry's shift towards EVs and bring our technologies that were very successful on the conventional engine side into the EV space. The same we are seeing now more on the safety and autonomous front. Autonomous is something that has developed very quickly. 5 years ago, the industry had very little to offer. Now we're talking about level two plus, right? Level one and level two have been around for some time. Level two plus is new, and we have a solution called DriveCore, which is the industry's first open technology for building this type of system that allows cooperation and collaboration by other players. Mm. We fundamentally believe that for this industry to really develop, you cannot do it with just one company doing it alone.
Yeah.
We need to bring the best of breed partners. So we decided to build an open platform that offers the core capabilities of our software tools, and this has been very well accepted in the industry.
Okay, so delving more into this technology aspects, we would like you to share a bit more of the technical aspects as to what goes into the product design, what goes into this software development process. You know, like in the sense, I mean to say, what are the hardwares involved in these latest connected technologies, connected display technologies?
Right.
And the software processes as well.
Absolutely. So one of the new trends is about connectivity, making the car a application environment that is able to deliver cloud services. Right. In the past, these devices were closed devices. The software was static. Mm. They used often proprietary system, proprietary solutions. So we have been pioneering the use of Android operating systems on very modern silicon SoCs from suppliers like MediaTek or Qualcomm, and be able to offer this ability to run apps into the vehicle.
Oh.
Now, this is the first time it's being done. This does not exist today.
Yeah.
Our first launch is going to happen in about 3 months' time with a global OEM. I'm not able to share the name of the OEM, but it'll be out very soon.
Okay.
And this is a very exciting new development for us. So that's on the electronics and software side. A equally interesting thing is happening on the display technologies. So displays in automotive are really evolving very quickly. In the past, the displays used to be relatively small, flat, and rectangular. What we're seeing is the emergence of larger displays, 17 inch going up to 30 inches, pillar to pillar, and often also being curved and non-rectangular. This is a tremendous new capability, and we have developed some new technologies to build these displays at high volume inside our factories. So vertical integration of the display manufacturing capability. This between the displays and the electronics behind this are going to really transform the cockpit, make it a digital environment with much larger displays that will also improve the user experience, because what works in, say, your home or your office doesn't necessarily work that way into the car, but we can really customize it with our capabilities and bring a similar experience using our capabilities, using our unique technologies.
Now that you mentioned about the environment and the open platform being available for the other parties as well, we would like to know, is Visteon India, being specific here, Visteon India interested in any collaborations with, you know, one of the major technology players of India, or let's say a startup in India?
Yeah, we definitely are. So we are just starting this process of opening up our platform to India partners.
Okay.
We have been doing it at the global level,
okay,
because the initial application of the solution has been for global markets.
Hmm.
The next, what I'm really happy to see, all these new technologies that we talked about, whether all the cockpit electronic solutions or the display solutions, we're finding a lot of interest by Indian OEMs to bring that into India, which was not the case in the past. In the past, they would be focused on cost alone.
Yeah.
Now, I think the Indian consumer is one of the most sophisticated consumer. I don't need to tell you that India is leading the world in terms of mobiles.
Right.
There's an expectation that they can get the same experience inside the car.
Yeah.
And I'm very happy to share with you that we have two customers for India with these technologies. I'm not able to share the names yet.
Ooh.
But as soon as we introduce this into the global markets, it's two OEMs from India immediately decided that they needed this for India. As an Indian, that makes me feel
proud.
Wow,
yeah, exactly. Even hearing that makes us really proud that Indian company led by Indian
Absolutely.
Is catering a whole new products for the Indian market.
And not only that, we have the teams here making an impact on the global stage. The technologies that I talked about earlier with this connected infotainment and being able to download apps, that innovation was done out of this office.
Oh.
Okay, and this is done for the first time in the industry. So we had a very interesting experience where when we delivered this system, it's almost ready, it's not shipping yet, it's almost ready. We delivered it to this OEM, it was a German OEM. They had several people from their team come to me and ask for whether they could talk to our engineers in India. I said, why would you want to talk to them? They said, we tried this with others, they were not successful. You guys have done a wonderful job. Can I please talk to your engineers?
Wow.
I said, okay, you can talk to them, but they are in India. So this tells you that our engineering talent is as good as anywhere in the world. I'm very happy. This is one of the best experiences I've had in my entire career in terms of bringing new innovation to the market, and this has been done out of this office.
You know, we are glad that we had a privilege to actually see the demonstration of some of the technologies that you mentioned.
Yeah.
And honestly speaking, we're really impressed by that. So
it's done out of this office. A large portion of that is done out of this office. So I think we should all feel proud about what India can do, given the right opportunities. So I'm absolutely a big believer that the talent is there.
Right.
Sometimes the opportunities are not. So we think from outside, we can bring the opportunities and then marry that with the talent that's here.
Perfect.
Then we should be able to do a whole lot more.
Yeah.
So that's a great story that I hope more people in India recognize their own capabilities and be able to do even more, given our own experience, which I think that's very possible.
Yeah, that's rightly said, sir, that we should be, as a technology leader, as the leader in this segment, you should be the one giving out more opportunities. So as a leader again, we'd like to know, what is your forecast, what is your prediction for 2020 and for the coming 5 years?
So we had a very good 2019. In the third quarter of 2019, while the industry was down, we grew by about 10%.
Oh.
That is an amazing achievement. There was no other competitor of ours that was even flat year over year. We grew 10%, the others were down. We will see a similar experience or similar performance in the fourth quarter. We haven't announced the results yet. They will come out very soon. And I'm very confident that we'll have a very good fourth quarter growth. And 2020 is going to be a big growth year for the company.
Oh.
While the rest of the industry is down. So why is that happening? Because we're taking market share. And my prediction for the future for Visteon is from 2020 onwards that we'll continue to see growth faster than the market, taking market share. So I'm here this trip also to look at how can we support that growth.
Right.
How can we make sure that we have the right talent? We have invested in adding to the capacity here. We're opening up more space so we can hire more people.
Okay.
So we're very excited about it. And it's all to drive the growth that we see ahead of us.
Okay. And thank you, sir.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much.
It's a pleasure talking to you.
Yeah, seriously. Thanks
for coming by.
Thank you for sharing your insights where this industry is heading to. So thank you, sir. Thank you.
Absolutely.
Very much.
Good luck to you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. That was Sachin Lawande, President and CEO of Visteon Corporation. Thank you. This is Ujjal Nair signing off.